Cedar Fair is one of the biggest amusement park chains in North America. They have parks across the United States and even one in Canada. I have been fortunate enough to visit a lot of these parks, and I've been wanting to rank them up. However, missing out on a select few would really mess up these rankings. Instead, I will list them based on each park's coaster lineup, not necessarily how the overall park stacks up to each other. Let's get into it. A quick note, no water parks will be featured on this list, just the dryland parks. I feel like that's pretty obvious, but I just want to make that clear. For these rankings, I first looked at the amount of quality roller coasters. This excludes kiddie coasters. I also looked at the types of coasters in each lineup. The parks with the more high-class coasters, such as Giga Coasters, are closer to the top. With that being said, let's get onto the first park in the list. Starting off at the very bottom is Michigan's Adventure. Let's be honest, who didn't expect this park to be at the bottom? They have a total of 5 noteworthy coasters, the best of the bunch being Shivering Timbers. Of course, this park isn't going to be able to stand up to Cedar Point, Kings Island, and some of the other parks on the list with just one standout coaster. Yeah, Shivering Timbers is good, but it's not that good. Even if it was Steel Vengeance, it wouldn't be able to do that. Michigan's Adventure also lacks the supporting coasters, like a Solid Invert or Looper. Yeah, they have Thunderhawk, but it's an SLC. Need I say more? Moving up one spot isn't much better than Michigan's Adventure. This spot goes to Dorney Park. Dorney features 5 coasters just like Michigan's Adventure does. It's really crazy to see the difference in amount of love and hate that each park gets. I feel like Michigan's Adventure is a laughingstock, and Dorney is considered a lower tier Cedar Fair park. Of course, this park does have a gem in Talon, the Grip of Fear, a really good inverted coaster. It also has some nice supporting coasters like Hydra, the Revenge, a nice floorless coaster, and an okay Hyper in Steel Force. To be honest, I found Steel Force to have a little bit of airtime, which seems to be very rare in this coaster. But just on that top 3 alone, Dorney is easily able to move above Michigan's Adventure. However, due to the lack of abundance of coasters, Dorney only makes it to spot number 10. The first 2 choices on this list are pretty easy to predict, but now we're going to get into a little bit more controversy. Coming in at number 9 is Worlds of Fun. Now this is one of the parks I haven't been to, but again, this is just looking at the roller coasters. Worlds of Fun features 6 coasters. The best of the bunch being Prowler, an amazing looking GCI creation. Additionally, this park has a great invert and an okay looking Morgan Hypercoaster. A great top 3 that is probably better than Dorney's. This park also has a bit more supporting coasters, including a spinning coaster. The reason that I said the last pick was controversial is because I think Worlds of Fun and Valley Fair are received very similarly. Valley Fair is the other park I have not been to. But naturally, Valley Fair comes in 1 spot above at number 8. This decision comes based on 2 things. First, based on what I've seen, Renegade seems to be the better GCI compared to Prowler. Second, and a more reasonable answer, Valley Fair has a better supporting lineup. The park does have an additional coaster to help its case. Both parks have a Morgan Hypercoaster, so it really comes down to those supporting coasters. In this case, I think Excalibur seems to put Valley Fair over the top. That Aero Mine Train coaster seems to be a sleeper. Moving on to the number 7 spot, California's Great America jumps into action. This is another park with 7 coasters. And for a very similar reason that Valley Fair is above Worlds of Fun, CGA is above Valley Fair. First off, Gold Striker is one of the best GCIs out there, better than Prowler and Renegade. Second, this park has the better supporting coasters, including a B&M Invert, a Floorless Coaster, plus a Wild Raptor from RMC. There's also some others that I won't mention. Moving on from that, we're now going to get into the more heavy hitters in the chain. Previously, the parks would go up by 1 or 2 coasters at a time. Now we're going to take a big jump in amount and quality. So next up is King's Dominion, coming in at number 5. This park has had a rocky last couple of years, losing one of its most famous coasters. Even with that, the park still features 11 coasters, Intimidator 305 and Twisted Timbers being among the top of the food chain. Plus, the park has another coaster set to open next year. That of course is Toombili, the 4D Freespin. Since this park lacks that third standout coaster to comprise a great top 3, this is as far as it will go. The real reason it makes it this high is from its unique cluster of supporting coasters, among the bunch being a rare bobsled coaster. From this point on though, the parks have a great top 3, and some even reaching a top 5 point. So coming in at number 6 is Knott's Berry Farm. This park features 9 coasters. Yes, this is less than King's Dominion, but hear me out. While some of them are less thrilling, they are super unique. This is where quality control is going to come into play. I'm talking about Montezuma's and Pony Express, which are outstanding smaller coasters. And who can forget the main events? Accelerator, Ghost Rider, and Hang Time. That's an amazing top three consisting of a launch coaster, wooden coaster, and inverting coaster. That's paired with the funky B&M invert to support. Those four coasters with the unique supporting coasters easily puts Knott's above the other parks and just above the halfway point. Now moving within the top four parks in the chain, things may get a little complicated. I found this choice very hard to make, but coming in at the number four spot is Canada's Wonderland. This park has a whopping 14 coasters, but will only make it this far. The top three consists of a Hyper, a Giga, and a record-breaking dive coaster. And there are just so many supporting coasters ranging from fun family rides to interactive coasters. With that being said, there is a major setback in the quality of some of these coasters. There are a couple that come to mind right off the bat. Flight Deck, the Rough SLC, and Time Warp, one of the jankiest roller coasters I've ever been on. There are a couple others that I think of too, but those aren't the worst to me. And because of that, Canada's Wonderland is only able to make it to the number 4 spot. Next up is a park that features one of the world's best roller coasters. That park is Carowinds, which comes in at number 3. I would say this park has a top 4 rather than a top 3. Fury 325 is among those. That alone is able to put this above some of the other parks in the list. In combination with Copperhead Strike, Afterburn, and Intimidator, this park is stacked. However, Carowinds only sports 11 coasters, which is not going to be enough to take on the remaining two parks. It was able to overtake Canada's Wonderland based on quality, but now it's time for quality and abundance, which Carowinds falls a bit short of. So coming in at the runner-up spot on this list is my home park, Kings Island. This park sports 12 noteworthy coasters, and I find it hard to rank a top 3. There are just too many good coasters here. The Beast, Mystic Timbers, Banshee, Diamondback, and even though I hate to say it, Orion. But in all seriousness, this coaster collection is world class, and the supporting coasters are great too. With every addition to the park, I feel like Kings Island is slowly overtaking Cedar Point. One day, I think that will be the case, but that's a topic for another time. As of right now though, KI is still in the shadow of their crown jewel. That leads right into the number one pick for this list. There's really no competition, and it's pretty obvious that Cedar Point hits the number one spot. It's impossible to give this park a top 5. Most of their coasters rank among the best in the world for each class. Some examples of that are Steel Vengeance and Maverick, both of which take my 1 and 2 spot of all-time favorite coasters. And just to give perspective, Cedar Point has 14 major roller coasters, while the parks at the bottom have 5 to 6. That's around triple the amount of coasters. And I could go on and on about the amount of coasters this park has, along with their quality. But I don't think I really need to go into that to show why Cedar Point is the number 1 spot. So that's pretty much going to conclude this list. I had made this video for a couple of reasons. First off, I thought it would be cool to see the coaster lineups ranked without any bias of experience like food options and cleanliness. It also somewhat shows the food chain and Cedar Fair's company. This is very interesting and can help to predict which parks will get new coasters next. For example, Kings Dominion had once been closer to the top and has been trending down, so now we are seeing more investments into that park. Obviously, there are more factors that play into new additions, but this order does have some say. The top dogs in the chain, like Cedar Point and Kings Island, seem to be getting constant investments, while Michigan's Adventure and Dorney Park, which are on the lower side of the chain, don't seem to be getting as much. I just find that to be a pretty interesting statistic. And I think that's a great way to wrap up this video. So what do you guys think of these rankings? Would you change any of them? Let me know in the comments below, because I know there are some controversial ones. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to leave a like and subscribe if you're new. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you next time.